following is a presentation of TFNN. The Global Market Pulse with your host, John Logan. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, John Logan.
Hi, guys. Hope you guys are having a good Monday morning. It's good to be back on TFNN. Had a good trip to San Diego. It was difficult to, I found, to stay up till 2:30 in the morning Eastern time and have dinner, do meetings, the whole nine yards, and get up at 4:30 in Eastern time and catch the TFNN show. So we just gathered momentum while I was there. But a lot of cool things happened out there. Had some excellent meetings with some folks out there that are some pretty large players. There's so many, my God, in that area between San Diego and L.A., that Orange County area. There's so many funds out there. Sick amounts of money. Whew. Crazy. And the weather, I'm not going to complain. 60 at night, 70 during the day. Just, possibly better than Hawaii. I was just blown away. No rain, though, ever, seemingly. They have a huge desalination plant they've built down there. If anybody's listening to the show from out there, I know I'm preaching to the choir, but amazing how dry it is. We're going to take a look at a couple of things going on overseas first today. Let's take a look at the Shanghai and the Hang Seng. This is the weekly on the Shanghai. A little bit more disturbing news out of nothing unexpected. Slowdown numbers, not exactly on support yet. Last week, we went down as low as 2781, kind of bouncing up on a Monday here on the Shanghai. But I don't really have a lot of faith in this being a good inflection point to play off of. And how's that affect the U.S. markets? We're going to talk about that in a little bit. But we're going to look at the Hang Seng. We don't look at this too often. Larry talks about it periodically. And Tammy, I commend you fully now on getting up that early in Vegas. That was it's even rough getting back on this time zone. But here's the situation on the Hang Seng. Had a little bit of a wild day over there today, but and had a little bit of a fat finger flash crash situation for a little bit, but 20,065 is going to be that resistance now. I think a lot of these Asian indices are probably going to slough off a little bit more. We're going to take a look at the DAX really quick. Came down and found support on the daily, but again, I don't have a lot of lofty aspirations that this is going to continue to to bounce. So as we look at all this, surf the globe a little bit, we're going to take a look at the Bovespa. Here's the situation there. We had that kind of oil, green shoots happening. A lot of these oil countries have rallied a little bit. But again, we've got support here, 51,196 on the weekly. But Goldman Sachs finally came out with, hey, wow, we think oil's going to go up. So they must be ready to get out of a long position. So that's why they're tooting the horn that everybody should get long so they can get out. And that's the way that goes. You guys know that if you've been trading for a while. A lot of these guys come late to the party and then give it the last fundamental rah-rah before they need to get out of their positions. That being said, we're going to hit all really quick. And we're going to look at the XLE relative to this in a second. But, this is the June contract. I want to go to the weekly for a second. This is why, you know, in my opinion, trading technicals, I mean, Goldman Sachs seemingly gave some fundamental news today that, hey, there might be some disturbances and oil's going to go straight up. And they really came to the party extremely late. So we started talking about on this show, and I think Larry was talking about it also in the next hour, about how, you know, it was a little bit, you know, we always try to block out one side of the marketplace. And even though this particular contract was well below profiles, we started getting those hints that it was probably more riskier situations to be short. And we had a big divergence happening here on our Navigator. And at the same time, we were able to, on our daily, start getting back into a situation where we could lean on 30. So we had the crossover happen also above zero Navigator, clearing this 37 general area, 37.5. But we started looking at this that it was not okay to be short and okay to be long back in this area down in here. And that was a different contract. I believe that was the Feb contract. So, you know, what do you do with this now? It looks like crude is clean and cleared 46.35. We used support recently. We talked about 42.93 down into 42.06, I believe was that number down there, 42.06 weekly unfair high, daily unfair low. We talked about that being somewhat of a collection area for this and a way to play defense. We've reached the targets up top, 46.35. By all means, oil. I'm going to go back to our weekly. This is our weekly on oil. Looking at 42.06 is that really big technical break that happened. But again, you know, you have some fundamental news like this, all seemingly traversing north again. I'd watch out for this. We could have some people getting out of this position right now, even though, again, I understand we're above profiles. I'm going to go back to the scanner, see if we can pull that up, and I'm going to show you the cell structure here. Going to our futures section and looking at crude oil, I mean, we're green across the board. You need some red shoots, if you will, to start looking at this and something to lean on to play defense if you're going to short it. But again, you know, this consolidation and this kind of move higher today, technically speaking, is pretty strong. But again, when somebody comes out with big fundamental news like Goldman Sachs that, hey, it's time to get long, you got to be wary of that in general. You guys know that if you've been trading for a while. So again, I'm not exactly super excited about getting long this thing. And we're going to take a look at the XLE really quick. And considering that the XLE and the XLE stocks, I mean, we're trading what this morning? 65.69. That's a real print. So we're above these weekly unfair highs again. But a little bit of a lagging situation here on the confidence as far as the stocks go relative to crude moving up. So we're going to talk about that a little bit more when we come back, guys.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. John takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the show. And we're finishing up with the XLE. Printing higher than the weekly on fair high, 65.27. Not exactly impressed with the way this is acting, or a lot of the oil stocks are acting right now. Looks like a lot of them have broken down. I was looking at the scanner right then. So, again, I'm not exactly super pumped about buying oil up here, buying this latest breakout. Here's the June contract. And I understand we've had a pretty big move pre-market this morning. But, again, this is something you might want to, you obviously got a chance to play defense 46.35, but again, I'm not super impressed that this is going to last. Take a look at the XLU. We're going to get into that really quick. Then we're going to hit some currencies and some other things that we got to cover this morning. This has been one, you got to love this. And relative to the 10-year and the market in general, looks like we're kind of doing a little bit of a crowding action here again. 49.88. I know this sounds crazy. I missed the super back the truck up thing at 46.04. Didn't quite get there. But again, in my opinion, this is one to block out the short side completely. Not a lot of reasons to short this particular stock, or excuse me, this particular ETF. And you can find some great opportunities in the XLE, in the scanner. Some more usual suspects. We got to look at gold here. And again, I know we had a little bit of a pullback last week. We're starting to move up now. Again, let me get this straight here so I can see it. Okay, there we go. So again, where do you play defense? You've got some intermediate areas, 1253, 1254. We talked about that. Last Tuesday, looks like we reached a low of 1258. So, again, nothing really in danger here as far as the long term. Here's the weekly. And, again, the only thing you got to play defense against is 1253, 1254 on that. Silver. Some leverage, the ability to play defense against 1698, let's just call it 17, stops down below there. Still not opposed to buying gold or silver now. We're going to take a look at the dollar. before we hit a lot of other commodities. We got back above 94.12, 94.13 on the dollar, closed above. Now you've got to, you know, that this is not the land of shorting things right here as far as the dollar goes. 93.81, 94.12. We talked about that being somewhat resistance. Now it's being looked at as support. Had a little bit of a technical damage here. What does that do to the rest of the commodity group? Commodities are acting relatively well. Let's take a look at the bean situation. This is the November contract. We've got the July contract in the scanner. Here's the daily, excuse me, here's the weekly on beans. There was that big breakout 915. We all know that last week, just an incredible move up. But let's take a look. You know, where do you wait patiently to buy support again now? 1038 on the November contract. And on the July contract in here, when I go to the futures section in the scanner, there's the numbers there. 1042. Let's just pull up the landscape situation. On a relative scale, about the same situation as the November contract, 1042 on the July. All right, let's hit some currencies really quick. Here's the yen trade. You know, we talked about this, targets ultimately being 110.40. I'm still liking this trade up into 110.40. This is one where, again, you know, Joey and I were talking about this, and I'm trying to figure out where Joey is right now. I know he's in Shanghai. I don't know if we'll be able to grab him before the end of the show. I wanted to have him on. And then RJP had mentioned he'd love to hear his voice also, as opposed to mine. But 110.40. Those are the targets still. This 105.5 we talked about was a big kind of back the truck up situation relative to a big hole in the marketplace that had happened before. And then that collection area down here between 105.5, 106, and we hit, 2 weeks ago, we reached a low of 105 and, you know, and a half. And how do you kind of regulate this trade up? You look at the dailies now. You can play some defense around 108.09. I like how this thing is consolidating above these unfair highs on the daily after we had reached those critical lows. And now you've got a chance to kind of raise your stops and look at this again as a decent risk-reward ratio up into 110.40 and maybe even a lot higher. If you get a weekly close on that above 110.40, then, you know, you should be sitting on the sidelines a little bit after that number. But this is been a nice little situation. Let's take a look at the Aussie dollar. This is one that, of course, broke my heart, getting below 74.81. But that's what stops are for, and that's what the profiles really tell me, where it's not okay to be long anymore, not okay to nibble whatsoever down below that profile. And that was some serious technical damage that happened. So, you know, what do you do with this now? I think this is kind of a no trade right now on the Aussie dollar. It's been a no trade for a while. I'm not a big fan of going short it. But again, it told me specifically that it wasn't okay to be long anymore. This is another thing factoring in the oil trade. Canadian dollar, again, seemingly looks like it wants to crowd this, move higher, and that would mean becoming more devalued. And that is a little hint, another hint when it comes to trading oil and not really wanting to buy this breakout. If, you know, this is just something you don't want to see. Okay. So it looks like this thing might pop, and I'm not a big fan of going long crude right now, even though we're technically looking okay. The euro. God, what a mixed up bag here this has been. So 114.17, 114.5, or excuse me, 114.64 to be exact. You know, what do you do with this thing? Again, I think we're kind of in no man's land down here. Here's the weekly. Sorry for bouncing around, John from Philadelphia. I'm trying to cover all too much here on the charts. You know, we kind of did a reversal 2 weeks ago and closed back in the box on the long term. again, this thing's just probably going to chop around. If you're looking at trading the euro, then I think you should go down to lower term time frames in the scanner. You can hit the Forex section and just find out where the inflection points are. But there's not a lot of leverage here. As you can see, we're gray across the board. That means that if you look at the landscape view in the scanner, we're just basically right in the middle of profiles all the way across the board. And I just don't see, you know, huge odds potential on this particular trade either way right now. We'll be right back, guys.
An active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments? Then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, don't miss out on the MarketSafe Commodity Solutions CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi guys, welcome back to the show. We're looking at Facebook right now. This is the daily. Let's take a look at the weekly. And again, after the news, talked about 113.5, 114.5 being support on this, reached a low last week of 116.5. So again, this thing's not looking back. We talked about, you know, is it okay to try to short something that's gone too high? This is another glaring example of why not to do that. This is a scary stock, as far as trying to play around with it on the contra trade. You just got to look for support on this situation. Keep it boring. Not try to be a hero. So Apple, here's the situation on Apple, that breakdown below 100 general neighborhood. And we actually didn't rally back up into that area, which is disturbing to be able to get some super shorts off. But here's the, you know, here's the latest inflection points here, 93.81. Last week, we talked about this kind of consolidating, or Monday and even Friday the week before, talked about this consolidating now below 93.81 and using that as defense on the short side. Remember, some of these things, they're just not on sale to be able to be bought when this happens. They're doing this for a reason. We got into the 90 area. Is it time to start trading some contra trades? We're trading 91.86 this morning. The answer to that's no, in my opinion. You know, like Joey was talking about at one point, just leaving even one share on, short or long, can allow you to kind of understand and remember what the core thought process is on these types of trades. And, you know, having a core position, even if it's a couple of shares or a couple of contracts, kind of, you know, allows you to remember, you know, what am I really supposed to be doing? Let me step back from this. The long-term trade still is on the south side until we start, you know, having some new profiles to appear, even, you know, a weekly new profile attempting to appear would be great, but that's just not in order right now. Let me go to the scanner really quick. And let me just hit Apple. So as you can see, you're looking at the S&P 500. You're doing some filters. Apple's not on that long list. Let's take a look at Netflix. The Netflix model. All right. So last week we almost got down into that weekly on furlough around 84.17. Come on. Okay. So, you know, again, not the darling of the long world, but, you know, what do you do with this now? In my opinion, you could look at, we're trading 87.88, 88 this morning pre-market. You could look at this as, to some degree, a little bit of a, you know, bounce situation where you could have a trading situation, not an investment situation. Remember, this is a weak stock in a market that's been coming off, and Netflix has obviously been kind of spinning around down here and heading lower when it had a chance to relative to the market. Here's the S&P's pre-market. It looks like we're trading around 2043-2044, and again, you know, opening up lower, kind of rallying up a little bit here. These are our daily profiles. And the big daily numbers here are 2043, 25, and 2068, 75. So here's the weekly on the S&Ps. Trying to get some kind of idea about where these are headed. We're right in the middle of a fair auction on the weekly. We've got a kind of a mixed bag here on the daily and weekly long-term breadth. We had a crossover happen 12th or 13th. Let me blow this up for you. So, again, you know, where's the leverage? Mixed bag, middle of a profile. You know, the S&Ps could bounce around here a little bit. I don't see a lot of leverage trading the S&Ps outright right now. Put a gun to my head, still selling rallies on this. And if you've got stocks that have been showing themselves early being weak, going into the scanner and being able to find, I'm pulling up the dashboard here on the S&Ps, trying to find opportunities that are showing themselves weak right now, I think still is the name of the game. So if I come in here and just do a very, very simple sort, what's trading below profiles on the weekly and the daily, Hewlett-Packard, HPQ, let's take a look at this one. You know, this thing's, it looks like it's sitting on the cliff again. I'm pulling it up because it's bottom right there. Let me see where we're at pre-market here. Yeah. Quite a few other opportunities here. And if you want to look at stocks that have broken down recently, you can go into this little section right here called breakdowns. And what that's going to do is it's going to put on the radar screen stocks that are breaking down on the daily or the weekly, showing one on the weekly, one on the daily. You've had some breakdowns here. Caterpillar on both time frames. I like this sort a lot because it just kind of allows me. And here's Caterpillar. Let me blow this up for you. So what it's telling you is last week, you know, we closed below, kind of retested that, opened below, retested it. And Friday, we just clean and cleared the daily also. So again, this is one should be on the radar screen, breaking down for the first time in a while. Let's just look at another one in that similar fashion here. MAC. Whew. Yeah, good chances to play defense on the short side on that one. We're going to go back and take a look at silver really quick. Duck. Oh, my God. Favorite North Carolina town, Charlotte and Duck. You know, John from Philadelphia, did you used to go to, I'm sure Jay did this, go to Duck like, what is this, in the mid-80s or even earlier? Literally nothing up there. Now it's the land of the Bill Gates and Tom Cruise houses. I think that one of them built a 30,000-foot house on the beach in Duck, North Carolina. Blew my mind when I heard that. This was, what, 15 years ago? Nice place. I used to be a lifeguard at Duck, by the way, in the summer. True story. Didn't complain about that one. Let's take a look at silver. LBS, Lifeguard Beach Service. If you ever see those chairs that say LBS on it, spray painted, templated on, that's what I used to rent. Here we go. This is a daily on silver. We covered this earlier. 17 support on it now. Here's the weekly. Bigger support at 1644, 1645 on silver. We'll be right back, guys.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software. software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com. Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the show. We're going to take a look at SWN really quick. Oil stock. Here's the weekly. You know, no new really scary things happening on the weekly, even though we pulled back from 14. I know that's, what is that? $3.14. Doing the math. A little more than 20% pullback. But here's the daily kind of regulating the trade up. You got to put really hard stops below 1073. That's kind of where the technical breakdowns would happen. But it looks like we're printing this morning. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looks like we're printing 1163. I think this is kind of a sympathy thing with oil and the Goldman Sachs news. And, you know, I don't think they drove this thing up. But just the fact that a big house is saying, hey, it's time to buy something, concerns me, as we talked about earlier. But again, you know, this is kind of the daily collection area on this 1073, 1146. And, you know, would I buy it right here? I don't think you're wrong here to look at this as kind of coming back into support and nibbling around here. Here's the 240s. This was kind of, you know, we talk about, you know, going into lower term time frames. You've got a chance to kind of look at two time frames as how stingy you want to be on stops. So from whatever the 7.5 area up, we've kind of looked at this. The scanner's going to put this in your wheelhouse for you. Let's go back into the dashboard, or let's go back into the ETF and let's look section, and let's look at the XLE going down to SWN. So here's that, you know, you're going to be able to look at these 240s. And there's that number right there. So, again, you know, not looking terrible here to start nibbling on the long side from an intermediate fashion. But on this type of kind of regulation of the trade up, you've had two different areas to look at, you know, taking a stop out and maybe collecting yourself lower or waiting for another breakout on SWN. Let's take a look at Halliburton while we're in this section. Here's the daily. Here's the weekly. Okay. So, again, I don't think there's a lot of leverage looking at Halliburton here right now. You've got a little bit of a chance to play defense around 38.70. But again, as you know, I'm not a huge fan of buying oil right now. A lot of these oil stocks have just kind of sloughed off in the latest moves up in oil. A little concerning for that oil trade, I'll say that. And that Canadian dollar situation, we talked about that earlier, looking like it might get more devalued. A lot of these aren't great leading indicators for trading crude oil from the north side. Here's the XLE in general. Looks like we're trading 65.67 this morning. So we're trading just barely above 65.27 weekly unfair highs. Again, I don't think the leverage is to really get long a lot of oil-related instruments right now. The 10-year, let's hit that. Again, you know, the trade, in my opinion, has been to block out the short side for a while. We were able to kind of pick a nice little bid up on at 129. This is our weekly 131.30 is still up there. In my opinion, that's still going to be looked at as a target. And now you've kind of, you know, again, reached some intermediate inflection points here, 131.01, 132. What do you do with this now? You got support at 130.08, 139. And any new closes above 131.02 are going to have to be looked at as a new support level to move higher on this particular treasury. Let's go back into the S&Ps really quick just to give you some updates here. $20.43, $20.25 unfair lows. You know, do you sell this after it's come down from $20.80 last week? Do you still sell this? Again, you know, we talked about the breadth being a little mixed up. We're in the middle of a fair auction here on our weekly. I think you just got to wait and see on the S&Ps right now. Not a big leverage area. Here's ExxonMobil. This is the weekly on ExxonMobil. This is, you know, again, we talked about this 70-73 general area of very similar to crude oil when it was kind of doing its divergence thing. You know, we were making higher highs on ExxonMobil. Crude oil was making lower lows. But that kind of gave us a reason to start nibbling around 73. But coming up here and kind of consolidating and not wanting to back off of these inflection points, had obviously a move higher, 88. Trading 89 this morning. Here's the daily on ExxonMobil. I got a couple emails about this. That's why I'm talking about it. So, you know, you do have support around 87, 84 on this stock. That's where you'd orient stops. But I think we're not sitting in the driver's seat right now on the longs, all things considered, on any of the oil stocks. But, again, if you're trying to buy an oil stock, this is definitely one of the strong ones. Take a look at another stock, XL. This is a financial stock we talked about recently that had broken down that we talked about. Okay, well, you know, don't see this as the shining light of the financial world. Henceforth, it rallied. So 33.76. Again, we've got to get back down below that area now to look at it from the short side. That was the resistance area to try to pick a battle. We're only about 50 cents higher. But again, I'd like to see this lower to look at it again. We're going to take a look at the XLF really quick. As we look at this, again, you're going to have a new profile coming out this morning on the XLF. And hasn't acted that bad, but it hasn't acted that good. This is one we've been talking about staying away from, really. Put a gun to my head. I'd love to be shorting this. But, again, you're going to have new inflection points to lean on the XLF this morning. And those will be out there in the scanner also. XLV Healthcare. Pre-market, we are not printing yet. Here's the situation. Last week, got up right into that inflection point, 70.82. I think we're going to head lower targets down below 67.60 on the XLV. Have we hit natural gas? We haven't hit natural gas, have we? Let's hit that really, really quick. This is the June contract. Just reading the den here. I cannot read and talk at the same time. Okay, so taking a look at natural gas. 2.072 is big support there. Looks like we're trading a little bit lower than that this morning. We'll hit that right when we come back, guys.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Catch Larry Pesavento, a 40-year veteran trader. He uses pattern recognition, Gartley's, butterflies, ABCs, and Fibonacci in order to trade these markets. Trade what you see next on TFNN.
Hi, guys. Welcome to the show. I was just lamenting about being at tobacco field when I was younger. Micro. He has not covered the dirtiest job yet. I don't care what that shows. The worst one, that's the worst. Okay, so natural gas, you know, we're kind of, you can look at this as a little bit of a promising situation. You know, when we have these technical breakouts and then they kind of consolidate, classical technical analysis type, you know, flag. It's a little deeper than I'd like to see a flag, but again, you know, you got to give yourself a little bit of noise level on this, and we could move a little bit higher here. Put a gun to my head, I'd rather be long than short. And again, I like the action, this divergence that happened on our navigator for a long term, you know, higher lows relative to lower lows on price action. And then we have the technical breakout, and that, you know, that's usually pretty powerful. So again, I'd rather be long than short this thing right now. If anybody wants to commiserate on the TFNN den about a dirty job, please type it in. That's always an interesting topic to me. All right, so got about 3 minutes left here. And what we want to do is we want to relook at Apple really quick. Pre-market, we're trading 92, a little bit of an action on the north side here. But again, you know, what's really happening here is the breakdown, 93-81, that's the big defense point. And again, basically all you're doing is getting back up into the unfair highs on the 240s. And remember, you know, things on their lows like this, they're not on sale. They're down here for a reason. You can pick up some, you know, some things on sale at times, but you need to see that technical damage. You really just don't have anything really here outstanding to look at as far as something to play defense against. As we've, you know, just like on the yen trade, we get down into that 105.5. We talked about that. That's the great risk reward scenario, at least to retrace back up in those weekly unfair lows. And this is urinating in the wind. Can we say that on the air instead of the other word? Anyway, S&P's just final thoughts here. Don't see a lot of leverage here either way. We definitely are coming down into some unfair lows on the daily, but again, a mixed bag on the breadth. The internals are all over the spitting in the wind. That's better. The internals are all over the place. If you go into the scanner, you look at the dashboard, you know, the breadth is just kind of flip-flopping around. We'll probably have just completely mixed bag across the board. That means to me, considering where the weekly is, you know, you always try to figure out, you know, do I have some really serious odds to put the trade on? If you're looking at the index itself right now, I don't think so. But if you can drill down into the internals and find some things relative to, you know, weakness or strength or ETFs, things like that, I still like the XLU sector. And I like to look at the strong stocks within there to try to increase the odds, for instance. So, again, you know, what's been breaking out lately? These are the stocks breaking out. I'm hitting the breakout section on the scanner. This is the definition of what a breakout is relative to the profiles. Here's one, NVIDIA Corp. Let's take a look at this one. Okay, there we go. It's actually off the charts. No mystery there. Let's take a look at Boston Scientific. Breaking out again up top above 22.25. Good old Monsanto. Here's the weekly. You can play defense now. 93.57 stops below. Guys, you've been great. Stay tuned for Larry. I'll be back again tomorrow. Have a good day trading.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.